Good Lord, didn't anybody here subscribe? Thank you.
Dr. Beverly Crusher, personal log, stardate 44821.3. Began an analysis today of the respiratory problems being experienced on the beta moon of Pelierzell. Finally got an actual letter from Wesley. Topped the class in exobiology, but he's still struggling in ancient philosophies. And there's someone new in my life.
Ambassador Odan, Dr. Crusher. I was just on my way to speak to you.
Hello, Data.
I've completed my study on the atmospheric variations which have occurred on the moon since the new technology was implemented.
Oh, thank you, Commander. That will be most helpful in my efforts to mediate the quarrel.
I could go over it with you now. It would not require more than 2 hours.
Oh, we do appreciate that, Data. But the Ambassador and I have set aside this time to analyze the incidence of the lung disease on the moon's inhabitants.
Then it is perfect timing, Doctor. What better occasion to integrate my results into your study?
Well, now that I think about it, you're absolutely right, Commander. Unfortunately, I'm not feeling very well. Perhaps Dr. Crusher could get you started inputting your information. I myself must return to my quarters.
Ambassador, are you still having those awful headaches? I'd better bring you a hypospray to take care of it.
I would be most grateful.
Put a cold cloth on your forehead, Ambassador. I'll do my best to be with you shortly. I'll set you up at the medical monitor, Data. It'll take you a while to input the figures, won't it?
At least an hour. But I do not believe much time can be saved by exhibiting such haste now, Doctor.
Data, there are times when every second does count.
Somehow I had an unnatural fear that Data was going to barge in and ask to discuss the peripheral effects of magnetospheric energy taps.
Well, if I don't get back soon and take a look at his projections, he just might come looking for me.
Do you know, when I first met the formidable Dr. Beverly, was it 10 days ago? I thought to myself, this woman is ice. Through to her bones. Who would have ever guessed, instead of ice, there is fire.
Don.
Stay here. Go.
Oh, Don. Are we... Is this interfering with your work on the Pelierzell problems?
Well, fortunately, I've done about as much as I can until we get there. Because I just can't seem to keep my mind on my work right now.
Odon? I have to go.
No! Promise me we'll be together tonight.
I promise.
Then you may go, Dr. Beverly.
It's just Beverly.
Not just Beverly. Beverly's smile, it's her kindness, her beauty within and without, so much more than just Beverly.
Picard to Ambassador Odan.
Yes, Captain, this is Odan.
Federation representative from Pelierzell has come on board. Would you care to meet us in the observation lounge?
I'll be right there, Captain.
of beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, oh beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, yeah.
I love beans, diggity doo.